Microsoft Defender for Cloud offers both agent-based and agentless security to provide a robust and flexible solution. In this video, I'll describe agentless cloud security posture management in our product. Agents are powerful, so why would you ever use agentless scanning? Simple. It's fast and easy to get started. In fact, you can get going tomorrow with almost zero effort and no impact on machine performance. For server scanning, here's how it works. After you turn it on, we make a copy of a resource's disk image into the same region as the VM. The agentless scanning environment is isolated per customer and subscription, and the disk snapshot is end-to-end encrypted at rest and in transit. Then, we perform a deep analysis of the disk snapshots that includes the snapshot's operating system configuration and file system. The scanning results go back to Defender for Cloud. Last, after scanning the image, we immediately purge the copied disk image. For containers, we use API-based scanning. To get started, you simply need to turn on these capabilities. There's nothing more. To do that, in Defender for Cloud, select Environment Settings, and then select the subscription you want to configure. You see Cloud Security Posture Management at the top. Foundational CSPM is free. Defender CSPM is a paid add-on plan. In Defender CSPM, select Settings to choose the agentless protections you want to enable. These are all in the Defender CSPM plan. Agentless scanning for machines looks for installed software, vulnerabilities, and secrets. When Defender for Servers P2 is enabled, it also scans for malware. Agentless discovery for Kubernetes is API-based discovery of Kubernetes clusters, including their configurations and deployment. Agentless Container Vulnerability Assessment scans images stored in the Azure Container Registry and in running images in the Azure Kubernetes Service for vulnerabilities. And last, Sensitive Data Discovery looks for managed cloud data resources that contain sensitive data. These same capabilities appear in other plans, like Defender for Servers P2 and Defender for Containers. After turning on Defender for CSPM capabilities, we'll start making recommendations to resolve the vulnerabilities we find. To see them in Defender for Cloud, select Recommendations. To show you an example, I'll quickly search for the term vulnerability and select Azure Running Container Images Should Have Vulnerabilities Resolved. The recommendation includes a description, any remediation steps, a list of affected resources, and a list of vulnerabilities sorted by severity. Select a vulnerability to see more details. Attack Path Analysis is another experience that uses the data from these agentless scans. In Defender for Cloud, select Attack Path Analysis. I'll search for Containers DCSPM Demo, since that's the machine I saw in the previous recommendation, and select the first attack path analysis to have a closer look. On the left side, you see the potential impact of this attack path, risk factors, and MITRE attack tactics that could be used to exploit it. The graph on the right side shows the attack path in a visual way. All that, plus you can query the data yourself by using Cloud Security Explorer. In this query, we're looking for Kubernetes pods running images that have high severity vulnerabilities. Agentless scanning is super fast and easy to get going and provides immediate benefits. To learn more about it, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.